This fight will be refereed tonight by Harold Vallon. Harold Vallon of New York City, a referee for 15 years, age 51. He has refereed many fights in the States, such as the Dick Tiger Jose Torres Championship fight for the light heavyweight crown. He has refereed internationally in Australia and Italy. And the point to remember is, again, you view some of the people at ringside to provide the local color here. The thing to remember is that the fight tonight will be scored only by Harold Vallon. There will be no judges, as we have in the States. Just one man will score the fight, not three men. Crowd begins to make some noises in the background, and I would have to think, as the trumpets get ready to blare, that it is Floyd Patterson. It is Floyd Patterson, of course, and they have been doing an amazing thing around here, a crowd of slightly better than 25,000 apparently in attendance despite the weather. They have been selling head and shoulder portraits of Patterson for a lot of krona. Each krona is worth about a quarter in American money. This man's appealed to these people ever since 1960, when he defeated Johansson to recapture the crown, is, as I said earlier in the show, incredible. And here is Jimmy Ellis. Says he's not one bit worried about fighting in what has become Patterson's second homeland. Ellis is not a talker. He is a fighter. And so Jimmy is in the ring as the fighters shadow box and generally warm themselves up. They should get a little help, by the way, from the television lights tonight in terms of warmth, and they're going to need it. Generally speaking, this colder weather would favor the younger man. System of scoring tonight will be on a round basis with a supplemental 1-4 point system if total rounds at the end of the fight are even. Ring announcer, whom you are hearing in the background, by the way, is Ben Grieve of Swedish television. Jimmy Ellis, you see, in that gold robe. He has towels under that, and Angelo Dundee, his manager, told me earlier that he might come in with two robes on, a second one under that, although it's hard to tell at the moment. Floyd Patterson in the black velvet robe with warm-up pants. Floyd usually starts slow. Haven't seen him sheathed in a towel that way recently. He usually starts slowly in his bouts, goes down, as you know, early and often, but has a penchant for getting up. They don't count him out on the floor. Tonight, Floyd said he was going to work long and hard in the dressing room to compensate for this cold. Getting back quickly to the scoring, or rather the rules of the bout, we will have the mandatory 8 count in the event of a knockdown. If a man gets up at 2, he still must face an 8 count. The 3 knockdown rule has been waived. If a man gets knocked down 3 times within a round, the fight does not automatically end. There is no saving by the bell. If a man gets knocked down 2 seconds before the bell rings, counting continues. Referee Harold Vallon is now coming into the ring. No saving by the bell, except, of course, for the 15th round. When the bell sounds there, the fight ends. This fight cannot be won on a foul. It cannot be lost on the foul. A referee, however, may penalize a fighter around for a foul. Fighters will be using 8-ounce gloves, as you see there, Harold Vallon. And this ring, just a note, is a small one, a 17-foot ring. And that's part of the shrewdness of Angelo Dundee. When he managed Muhammad Ali and trained him, and Ali was to fight Liston, Angie made sure it was a 20-foot ring so there'd be room for Ali to maneuver against Liston. Now Dundee thinks he's got the better puncher tonight than Ellis, and it's a 17-foot ring. When I asked Angie about it yesterday, because we measured the ring together, I said, Angie, small ring, only 17 feet. He said, plenty big. Big enough for my purposes. He's a shrewd one. He is a professional, Mr. Dundee. You're looking at Ellis, who weighed in at 198 pounds. He has become a full-grown heavyweight once he fought as a middleweight. He has won 26, lost 5 in his career, 31 bouts, won 12 by knockouts. Patterson, weighed in, as you see him now, at 188.5. His lightest weight since November 30th, 1956, when he stopped Archie Moore in the fifth round at Chicago Stadium to become the youngest ever heavyweight champion of the world. Don't forget, this is only the first of two great events today. Right after Wide World of Sports, you'll be seeing the opening of the NCAA season, Tennessee against Georgia, with Chris Schenkel and Bud Wilkinson, direct from Knoxville, Tennessee. Talking again about Floyd, he has won 46, lost 6, had one draw, that one against Jerry Quarry, won 35 by knockouts. When Patterson was younger, and it remains to be seen if he can come back to that kind of form, he had the swiftest hands in boxing, superb combinations of blows, and although it was not generally realized, he was truly a devastating puncher, which accounts for the 35 knockout. However, as I said at the very top of this show today, it remains to be seen if Floyd can draw upon some inner resource. Perhaps as Pancho Gonzalez did a week or so ago at Forest Hills when he defeated Tony Roach in straight sets. Jimmy Ellis. Jimmy Ellis, who is confident, but who will have to face tonight for the first time. And Angie Dundee said it was troubling Jimmy a bit in training. Patterson's famed peekaboo style. You'll recognize it the moment you see it.
Okay,
the two fists together, protectively up in front of the head. Look for Ellis to use the left hook to the body to draw those fists down. And also watch for Ellis's right uppercut. Ellis is a boxer puncher with all the blows. The jab, the left hook, straight right, the looping right. He can deck a man with either hand, as he proved against Bonavina. And he can knock a man out with one punch, as he proved against Johnny Pearsall on March 22nd, 1967 in Madison Square Garden. He knocked Pearsall, who was then apparently on the move in the heavyweight ranks, out in just one round. There is Jimmy Ellis's wife, Marietta, or at least you just saw her there, and there you see her again. Sitting next to her are two of Jimmy's brothers, Jerry and Eddie. We are coming closer to the beginning of this fight. They are, as you can see, taking off Floyd's warm-up jacket, and his warm-up pants will come next. Patterson has had a quiet confidence about this one, although still there has been some talk from him to this reporter, at least, of defeat. He has said, if I lose to Ellis, it won't be so bad because I'll be losing to a man who carries the championship well in and out of the ring. And I think that is an obvious allusion to circumstances that you're all very familiar with in the States. We await the start of this WBA heavyweight championship bout. Floyd Patterson and Jimmy Ellis. Ellis in the white trunks. Floyd in the blue trunks. Ellis, black stripe on white trunks. Floyd, white stripe on blue trunks. The bell for round one. Right uppercut there. No damage yet by either fighter. Ellis will not take Patterson cheaply. Come on, We have little more than a minute left in this round one. Ellis White Trunks, Patterson Blue Trunks. So far, nothing more than a feeling out round. The crowd will yell every time Floyd even seems to land. Seconds left in round one.
Another Schlitz, Bill.
Gosh, Charlie, I just ran out of Schlitz.
Oh, that's okay. Make it a... how about a... See, when you're out of Schlitz, you're out of beer.
There's just one Schlitz. Nothing else comes near. When you're out of Schlitz, you're out of beer.
Quality never comes easy. Schlitz is most carefully brewed for smoothness, gusto, and aroma without beer bite. This is pure beer. This is Schlitz.
If you like it light with a big taste too, there's only one brew that will do when you're out of Schlitz.
No second choice.
You're out of beer. Real gusto in the great light beer, Schlitz.
The beer that made Milwaukee famous.
We are back for round two. Ellis against Patterson. Ellis White Trunks, Patterson Blue Trunks. Seated at ringside, of course, are some of the great sports writers from around the world. Immediately next to me, Mel Derslag, syndicated columnist, Los Angeles Herald Examiner, and Milt Gross, syndicated columnist, New York Post. They are scoring this fight most unofficially. The only official score is the referee, Harold Fallon. And from time to time, because of their experience, we may allude to their scorecards as a barometer of how the fight may be being judged by the referee. Got in a good right there, as you saw, his best blow of the fight. Incidentally, the first round was scored by the two riders whom I mentioned to my left as Ellis's round. There is blood on the right nostril of Jimmy Ellis, the result of that right that Patterson landed earlier. We have little more than a minute left in round two. Ellis White Trunks, Patterson Blue Trunks. The action has been, as you can see, at best lukewarm up to this point. But blood from the right nostril of Ellis, the result of a Patterson right. There was a right by Ellis. Patterson's left jaw, but no damage. No knockdown slip. We will will go to Ellis's corner after this round. Take a look at that nose. 5 seconds left. Round two. End of round two, and we're going to focus on the WBA champion, Jimmy Ellis. They are working immediately on Jimmy's nose. Not a serious cut, by the way, but they want to stop the blood flow immediately. Serious cut, the blood would start to flow into the mouth, create a problem. The crowd is roaring behind us because a young Swedish screen actress comes in between each round to hold up the round card for the forthcoming round. And you will see her later in the fight. Terribly attractive. There sits Patterson. By the way, the general consensus around me is that Patterson won the second round. The rounds would then be even if they are correct. 1-1. The crowd is crying, Swedish, let's go Floyd. Round three. Now there is blood from Ellis's left nostril. Angie Dundee in Ellis's corner is right now talking to Cutman Chicken Ferrara about it. Two minutes left in the third round. So far, Ellis has not been able to get through, the peekaboo style. You see again Patterson with those fists up protectively in front of the face. That's the peekaboo. Patterson was hurt by an Ellis right. He is hurt now. Ellis must push him off to take advantage of it. That was no knockdown, slip again. But Patterson is in some trouble. 1 minute left in this, the third round. Perhaps you hear Angelo Dundee screaming, push him off. That's to provide punching room to Floyd Patterson. That hurt. That uppercut hurt Floyd. He grunted. Perhaps you heard it. Patterson with a flurry, but not damaging. 25 seconds left in this round. Cleanly, apparently, Ellis's round, as you can see.
Don Anderson is driving home from work in a Piper Comanche. Today, Don has covered 600 miles, made calls in four different cities, landed several contracts, and he's home in time for dinner. This weekend, the Anderson family will load up the Piper and head for their favorite lake. How about you? Wouldn't you like to fly? It's really very easy. Just visit your nearby Piper dealer and take the special introductory flight lesson he's offering for just $5. You'll fly in a sleek, good-looking Piper Cherokee with modern low wing. You'll handle the controls yourself with the guidance of an expert government-rated flight instructor. You'll find it a fascinating experience, a most rewarding sport. Why not visit your nearby Piper dealer and try this exciting special $5 introductory flight lesson? And for full information on flying, write for your Learn to Fly kit to Piper, Box 101, Lock Haven, Pennsylvania.
We're back for round four. Ellis against Patterson. Remember, you're watching the WBA World Heavyweight Championship fight on ABC, the number one network for sports, where more people will see more sports in 1968 than on any other network. Patterson in blue. Ellis in white. Patterson in trouble in the third round, though not down. Patterson fighting back with a flurry, beginning with the left hook. According to the scorecards of syndicated columnists Mel Derslag and Milton Gross, Ellis has two rounds, Patterson one up to this point. Good left by Patterson, and a good right too. Patterson's best combination in this fight, really, notwithstanding the blood on Ellis's nose in the first two rounds. Ellis had wanted to win this fight quickly, convincingly, to establish image. Blood again. Blood again from Ellis. 1 minute left in this fourth round, a good round for Patterson. Patterson beginning the fight with confidence. Gundy yelling from the corner, stick him, meaning keep the left jab up. Was hurt. A gut exchange. Ellis cut above the right eye. Ellis in trouble with that cut. The cut above the eye going into the eye. We're going to stay with you between these rounds because Ellis is being cut up. And if you see Ellis's face, you see a face of blood. And this crowd is going to go wild because of the way they feel about Floyd Patterson. And give this to Patterson. He is fighting tonight like we haven't seen him fight for a long, long time. That may relate to the way Ellis is fighting. You can't evaluate that. Not as the fight progresses. But Patterson is fighting courageously and he is hitting well. You're looking at Ellis. The corner man working on it. Angelo Dundee, the manager. The cut man, Chicky Ferrara. Angie himself working on the cuts. Dr. Ferdy Pacheco of Miami Beach, Florida, with Dundee in boxing through all the years. Over to Patterson, who is unmarked, who is sitting there with that stoic calm that has always been his, really, in victory or in defeat. But Floyd Patterson fighting with this crowd behind him and making himself some kind of fight up to this point. We go to round five. Patterson blue trunks, Ellis white. This is a 15-rounder for the WBA version of the World Heavyweight Championship. We are in round five. The unofficial scoring, just a barometer, next to me, has two rounds for Patterson, two rounds for Ellis. Damage has been done, the obvious damage to Ellis thus far. Cut over the right eye, cuts in both nostrils. Blood flowing in all but one of the first four rounds. Ellis not fighting confidently. Not at all. 2 minutes left. I think you can see that blood on Ellis's nose for yourselves. Cut is open again. Left in this, the fifth round. Ellis white, Patterson blue. Ellis bleeding from the right nostril, cut over right eye, not reopened. Seconds left. Round five.
News travels fast, and one of the first to hear is a member of the Allstate Insurance Company's special disaster team. A tornado in Texas, a hurricane in Florida, a windstorm in Oregon. He might get a call at any hour of the day or night to head for the trouble spot. He and other expert claimsmen from Allstate will be on the scene in a matter of hours. First, to set up emergency headquarters at the disaster scene, perhaps in a school gymnasium or even in a store. Then get to the Allstate policyholders and try to help them. For the homeless, find a place to stay. And most basic of all, help solve the money part so they can rebuild. For protection you can count on in an emergency, talk to the good hands people. You're in good hands with Allstate.
We're back for round six. Ellis white trunks, Patterson blue trunks. The fight so far a surprise to the so-called boxing experts. Patterson doing very well indeed. Unofficial scores at ringside show at two rounds apiece, one even. Patterson having cut Ellis's nose almost in the beginning and having scored a cut over Ellis's right eye in the fourth round. Just a slip. Third time this fight, Patterson has slipped. No knockdowns in the bout. Ellis's white trunks covered, as you can see, with his own blood. Left in the sixth round. Ellis now pursuing some of the tactics that Dundee had him use against Jerry Quarry, and in a strange way, perhaps reminiscent of Muhammad Ali, the sparring partner he was, as you know, for so many years. Again, there is blood out of Ellis's nose. blood over Ellis's right eye. Don't forget, immediately after Wide World of Sports, Georgia against Tennessee from Knoxville, with Chris Schenkel and Bud Wilkinson opening NCAA Game of the Year. One minute left in this, the sixth round. Blood coming out of Ellis's right eye again. What Ellis faces now, quite frankly, is the prospect that even if he should win this fight, he will not have impressed. There are 30 seconds left in round six. Ellis is in real trouble now. Patterson is fighting light at 188 and a half. Ellis heavy at 198, and Patterson is assuming the aggressor and commanding role. Take a look at Patterson scoring in slow motion. There. That right hurt him. There was no question about it. Now Dundee is right above us, saying that Ellis, work on him, work on him, work on him. But so far, Ellis hasn't been able to do much work on anything. As I look at the scorecards around me, Mel Derschlag, Milton Gross, nationally syndicated American columnist, the scores are, by Derschlag, 4 rounds for Patterson, 2 for Ellis. By Gross, 3 rounds for Patterson, 2 for Ellis, and 1 even. Only unofficial, just barometers. This fight will be scored only by Harold Valens, the referee. There are no judges. And we are in round 7.
I'm Bud Palmer, New York City. There seems to be some distortion with Howard Cosell's commentary from Stockholm, Sweden. We will continue. We're in the 7th round. That's Patterson in the blue trunks, who's been scoring extremely well. Turning point was the 4th round, but a hard left then by Jimmy Ellis. Patterson scored beautifully in the 4th round and has been assuming command of the fight since that time. About 2 minutes to go now in the 7th round. Patterson in blue. Seemed to score again with the right hand. Of course, the crowd over there really prejudiced towards Patterson. It's hard to tell. This is live from Stockholm. And Ellis, throughout the fight, has been trying to get in that right hand, which he's noted for, but so far, Patterson has been avoiding it. This is the 7th round. Ellis is cut at the nose and the right eye. No damage to Patterson so far. Patterson was in trouble in the 3rd round. 1 minute to go now in the 7th. WBA World Heavyweight Championship fight, live on the satellite from Stockholm, Sweden. Patterson fighting with confidence in blue. Oh, and there's a hard right. A little high, I believe, by Ellis then. Caught Patterson high on the forehead. As I mentioned, Patterson fighting with confidence. Ellis seems confused. Final moments now of round number 7. Patterson countering after Ellis missed with that combination. No damage done. And now the combination's coming from Patterson at the bell. And we'll return with more of ABC's Wide World of Sports, but after this message from our local stations.
The Outcast premieres Monday, September 23rd on ABC.
Ringside, Howard Cosell, round 8, Ellis against Patterson. Ellis in the white trunks, they are bloodstained. Patterson in the blue, he remains unmarked. Patterson waging a surprising fight to all of us, and probably slightly ahead as we have gone thus far.
Once again, there seems to be some distortion on Howard Cosell's live commentary from Stockholm, Sweden. The satellite or the bird is giving us a beautiful picture but having trouble talking. So I'll carry a little bit here from New York City till we can get Howard Cosell back. In case you just joined us, this is the World Heavyweight Championship fight. Floyd Patterson in blue, Jimmy Ellis the champion in white. And so far the fight has gone to Patterson. It turned in the fourth round when Patterson stunned Ellis with a hard right, had him in difficult trouble, and since that time, Patterson seems to be in control of the fight. Ellis fighting back in white. He's still strong. He was cut around the nose, but more serious over the right eye. Eighth round from Stockholm, Sweden, live. We're halfway through the eighth round now. Patterson more and more becoming the aggressor. Ellis still trying for that sneak right hand, has yet to land it properly. A miss then by Patterson in blue. And a miss by Ellis, leading with right. Last minute of the eighth round. It's been a very clean fight so far. Well handled by Harold Ballin, the referee. There are no judges. It's a referee's decision solely. Now Ellis fighting back. Fine right then by Patterson, looked like it landed. And Patterson fighting and hitting the better combination seen him throw in years. Waning moments now of the eighth round. And now let's go to Chris Schenkel in Knoxville, Tennessee, getting ready for that Tennessee-Georgia game. Chris?
Okay, Bud, and here in the foothills of the Smoky Mountains from our Goodyear blimp hovering above Neyland Stadium, both teams are out on the field in their preliminary warm-ups. And, of course, speaking of the teams, Tennessee, ranked number 2 last year with a 9-2 record. They are the defending Southeast Conference champions. And today they are meeting the University of Georgia Bulldogs for the first time since 1937. The last time they played, Tennessee won 32-0. A significant feature of this game, Tennessee helps to celebrate the beginning of the 100th year of intercollegiate football with a new plastic playing surface, the tartan turf. And it'll be most interesting to see how these two teams play on this flawless field here in Knoxville, Tennessee, and that'll be forthcoming here on ABC Live and in color. Now let's return to the fight from Stockholm, Sweden.
Back at ringside for the start of round nine, Howard Cosell reporting. Ellis against Patterson. Patterson blue trunks, Ellis white trunks. Patterson in the best shape I've seen him in years, fighting a courageous and very good fight. Ellis fighting, to put it mildly, a disappointing fight. Ellis's left eye partly closed, cut over right eye, reopened intermittently, blood flowing from the nostrils throughout the fight. In the blood from Ellis's nose, reopened almost immediately with the start of every round. Left in the ninth round. Ellis sluggish, unable to take advantage of opportunities, troubled perhaps by the peekaboo style. From Ellis's corner to push Patterson away. Ellis did have a flurry there, but did no real damage to Patterson, who's fighting more confidently with every passing round. Little less than a minute left in round nine. Patterson blue trunks, Ellis white. By Patterson that hurt Ellis, and yet Ellis is now hurting Patterson. What
do you think, Dave?
It's a toss-up.
Well, for your purposes, I believe this saddle suits you best.
I think you're right. I would like covered stirrups.
Sure, I can fix that up right away.
She could fix this pipe, too.
What's wrong?
Oh, I don't know.
He's hot.
Harsh.
Here, try some of my Sir Walter Raleigh.
Smells grand, packs right, tastes great, can't bite, keeps fresh. So fresh in the pouch.
44% fresher. Enjoy the rewarding taste of Sir Walter Raleigh's Great Tobaccos. A blend of 100% Kentucky Burleys, extra aged to the peak of mildness for rich, good flavor. Relax in a man's world with Sir Walter Raleigh.
Okay, Dave. She's all fixed.
Fine. And so's this pipe. Thanks to your tip on Sir Walter Raleigh.
Sir Walter Raleigh. Sooner or later, your favorite tobacco.
They're back at ringside. Ellis against Patterson. Patterson surprising all of the experts by waging a courageous and very effective battle thus far. We understand that there's been audio breakup from time to time on the telecast. Hardly any matter. The pictures speak for themselves. Dundee fellow corner men, the men who handle Ellis, are becoming openly concerned. Getting three different advices from the corner as Patterson hit him with a right, but that did not damage Ellis. Getting one piece from Angelo Dundee, another piece of advice from Chris Dundee, Angie's brother, and a third piece from Sticky Ferrara. I look at the unofficial scorers around me. Milton Groves has it four rounds apiece and one even, with Patterson having inflicted the greater damage. Mel Derslag has it four rounds Patterson, three Ellis, with two even. Remember, these are just a couple of prominent columnists who keep their own scores. Nothing official. The fight is being scored by just one man, third man in the ring, Harold Vallon of New York.
But more men like to start with the comfortable fit and good looks of Hager slacks. Hager Forever Press slacks of Acrylan Acrylic and Rayon hold on to a crease, bounce out wrinkles like a pro. Then, too, there's that Acrylan wear-dated guarantee for one full year's wear or your money back.
And when he's feeling frisky, he can just let go.
His Hager slacks are going to keep right on looking trim and crisp. Oops, wrong pew, Buster, but no matter. Heat and humidity are no sweat to Hager Forever Press slacks. That fresh-pressed look will last through heat and hot water. Even when they get soiled, just chuck them into a washer and forget it. No ironing ever needed. And for the young swingers, Hager Forever Press slacks also come in the slim Mustang model with color-coordinated belt. It's wear-dated, too. So when you want to be well-dressed and comfortable, too, start with Hager slacks. They just fit better, naturally.
Round 11. Ellis, white trunks, Patterson, blue. Round 11. Ellis thus far has made scant and ineffective use of the left. Left jab and the hook.
Come on.
Once again, we're having a problem with the audio from Howard Cosell. This is Bud Palmer again in New York City. That's Patterson in the blue trunks, under 1 minute left in round 11. Patterson unofficially out ahead in blue, staging a tremendous fight here. Patterson using his left very effectively. And great combinations by Patterson. Still he has to watch that tremendous right hand of Ellis.
Moving.
Round 12. Ellis now fighting for his life. One unofficial score next to me, Mel Derslags, says 6-3-2 Patterson. Milt Grosser says 5-4-2 Patterson. As you know, we are having an audio problem. Two minutes left in round 12. Ellis white trunks, Patterson blue. Patterson at age 33, giving the best fight of the past several years in his long boxing career. Another slip by Patterson. 1 minute left in round 12. Patterson has slipped four times, but has not been floored in this fight. Ellis came on in that flurry. Seconds left in this, the 12th round. We are back. Mercedes Stadium in suburban Stockholm for round 13, Ellis against Patterson. Between rounds, Angelo Dundee, manager trainer for Ellis, told me that Ellis's nose was broken in the first round of this fight, and he has been fighting with a broken nose ever since. Under the circumstances, the nature of Ellis's fight would be very understandable. Not an excuse. Patterson has fought a courageous fight, an effective one, a well-styled one.
and Ellis has been sluggish from the beginning and has been unable to use the left effectively and unable to penetrate the peekaboo style. Under any circumstances, by our unofficial scores around us, the fight remains close. One rider has it 5-5-2, the other 6-4-2 Patterson. One minute left, round 13. As people who follow boxing know, broken noses are common. And fighters have fought and won with them.
Blood coming out of Patterson's mouth now. Patterson fighting furiously. Swinging furiously, but not doing the damage to one another that the crowd believes. The end of round 13 will go to both corners. Ellis's face is a mess, as you can see. And again, Dundee, Ferrara, and Pacheco go to work on it. Patterson is much less marked, but beginning to show signs of being marked and suffered a cut inside the mouth in that last round, the 13th round. Incredibly, as we look at Patterson, incredibly, this crowd is counting on Floyd's victory. And you couldn't have found a boxing writer in this town who would have given a cent for Patterson's chances to survive the fifth round before the bout took place. Immediately, the blood pours from Ellis. And this is the 14th round. That nose, which was broken at the very beginning, has been bleeding throughout the fight. Come on. 2 minutes left in the 14th round. Floyd threw a right that did no damage. An excellent left by Patterson. Under ordinary circumstances, or they might have been extraordinary had this fight ended earlier, You would be seeing the pregame show right now for the Georgia-Tennessee game, which will be coming on right after Wide World of Sports. This fight now in the 14th round. Ellis Amass of Blood, Patterson fighting more confidently, steadily. 1 minute left in the 14th round. And at age 33, his fourth challenge in his boxing career, a good right lead by Patterson. Floyd Patterson may become the heavyweight champion again. This, the World Boxing Association version. Ellis went down. And he pulled Patterson down with him. 30 seconds left and missed the 14th round. Ellis is a bloody, pulpy mess. Patterson is virtually unmarked. The first knockdown, the only knockdown of the fight. Patterson to the left against Ellis. Patterson in complete control of this fight. That's the end of round 14. Let the crowd's noise speak for the way they feel. Over Floyd Patterson. Steve Klaus, Patterson's cut man. Final round coming up. Victory obviously within Floyd Patterson's grasp. A stunning upset in the offing. Look at Jimmy Ellis as against Patterson.
Harold Ellis.
We're back for round 15, and Harold Vallon just came over to tell this reporter and the others around me that he did not call that a knockdown of Ellis. That he said Ellis slipped and Patterson fell down with him. Still looked like a knockdown to me. Final round, Ellis white, Patterson blue. Patterson apparently in control of this bout. Patterson fighting his best fight in years at weight 188.5. Ellis with a broken nose since the first round, according to Angelo Dundee. Patterson belaboring Ellis all over the ring. 2 minutes left of the final round. Started for Patterson in 1952 with an Olympics victory. And then the many bouts in the Eastern Parkway Arena. And then the defeat of Archie Moore in 56 for the title. And the three bouts with Johansson. A lot of suckers in between, like Rademacher and Roy Harris and all the rest. Patterson again hitting Ellis with the left.
Or two. I don't necessarily say that was deliberately. It may have been the dressing room whistle. worth getting him out on time. But he's looking very casual about it, I must say. There he is.